Okay, so in this video, we'll be now talking about inverse Laplace transform of partial function, in which our we'll get first here the equation for or a partial function of the form, so n of s okay, so that will be n of s is equal to d of s, no? But in this instance, no, our d of s is a quadratic, no? A quadratic function, no? So meaning its degree, no? The degree of our this d of s, no, the degree of that is the degree is 2, no? Okay. So if that's the case, no, if our n of s is quadratic, no, so our n of s over d of s, if that is quadratic, no, if this one is quadratic, so we'll be just be using this one, a of s plus b over our d of s, no? D of s 1, if we have our first quadratic equation or quadratic function is d of s plus d, no? Over d of s 2, then plus if in case our d of s 2 is repeated, no? So you could have that one as e of s plus f over d of s 2 squared, no? So that is how we are going to get, no, the partial fractions of our given rational function in which the denominator is a quadratic function, no? To appreciate it, we'll also have here an example. So we have here, so we need to get the inverse Laplace transform of 16 over s, and that would be s squared plus 4 squared, no? So we need to get the inverse Laplace transform of this function, no? So this will be this one, okay? Solution. So solution. So first, we will copy our given rational function. So s squared plus 4 squared. Then what we are going to do is to reduce this one, no, to a partial fraction. So first we have here a linear, no? So that will be s plus, so a repeated quadratic, so that will be bs plus c all over s squared plus 4, then plus ds plus e all over s squared plus 4 squared, no? Then we go to multiplying our equation here with the denominators, no? So that will end up with 16 is equal to e times s squared plus 4 squared, no? Plus b s plus c times will be s times s squared plus 4 plus d s plus e times s, no? Okay, then after that one, so we'll just continue to expand this one, no? And then we will go on equating coefficients, no? So we'll have 16 is equal to a So this will be s to the fourth plus 8s squared plus 16. So we just expand this one, no? Plus this will become b. So you will first multiply our s here, no? So this will become b squared plus cs, okay, times squared plus 4, plus that we will have d squared plus es. As you notice, I just omit the parentheses, no, so that we will not be confused of this one as a function of s, but this is d times s, so not the usual notation of d as a function of s, no? Okay. So we have some space here. Okay, then we just continue expanding this one, no? So we have 16 is equal to a s to the fourth plus 8s squared plus 16 plus, so that will be this one times that this one, that will be b s to the fourth plus c s cubed. Then we have plus 4 b s squared plus 4 c s, no? Then plus d s squared plus e s. Okay, maybe I will just delete this one, so that will just be equal to 4 c s, no? 4cs. Okay, so now we will equate our coefficients, no? So equating, coefficients, no? So first we will go to s4. Okay, s4, so this side of the equation, so this side s4 is equals to 0, then we have a plus b, no? Then s cube, we still have 0, is equal to c, no? So c, so our c is equal to 0, no? From that one. Okay, then next we will have this move here. Okay, s squared. So s squared is still 0. Then we have 8a. Then plus 4b. Then plus d. No? Squared. And next we have s, so s that will be 0. We have 4c, and there will be no other e, not everybody s, but only e for this one, e. Okay, then for constant k, it will be 16. We will not add that one as k, but s to the power of 0, no? S 0, so that will be constant, no? So we have 16 for a, so 16a, then I believe there is no other one, no? For a, no? For the constant. Okay, so from this one we could say that 1 is equal to a, no? From this one also we could say that our c is equal to 0. So we just have that one first, equation 1, equation 2, equation 3, equation 4, and this will be our equation 5, no? We will say from 4, equation 4, So V0 is equal to 4z plus e. So we know that our c is equal to 0 from 2. So 0 is equal to 4 times 0 plus e. So our e will just be equal also to 0. No? Then next, we'll go to solving our b. No? So from 1, equation 1, okay, from equation 1, we could say that our 0 is equal to a plus b, and our a from equation 5, that is just equal to 1, so our b is equal to negative 1, no? The next from equation 3, no? So from equation 3, so that will be 0 is equals to 8a plus 4b plus d. So we have the value for our a, which is 1, so from equation 5, and b from this one, no? So it will be 4 times negative 1 plus d. Okay. Then 0 is equals to 8 minus 4 plus d, so 0 is equals to 4 plus d. Then solving for our d, we'll end up with negative 4 is equals to d, no? So as a summary, so our a is equals to is equal to 1, b is equals to negative 1, c is equals to 0, d is equal to negative 4, and e is equal to, so e is equal to 0, no? Okay, so if we're going to go back to our rational fraction here, no? We dissolve our rational fraction. Okay. So we're going to go back, no? We are going to copy just. We just have to copy this one. Okay. Okay, so this one. We're going to copy this one. We're gonna copy, maybe we'll just rewrite that one here, no? On our space below. Okay. So just enough to see the summary, no? The value of our a. Okay, so that will be, so this will be 16 over s squared plus 4 squared. So this will be equal to a over s plus bs plus d all over s squared plus 4 plus cs plus d all over s squared plus 4 squared. Okay, so we have now the value of our a, which is equals to 1, so that will be 1 over s, plus our b is negative 1, so we have negative s, plus d is no, this is not d, this will be c, no? This is also not C here, no? So that will be C, will be C, and this will be D, S, and this will be E. Okay. So this will be equal to 0 all over S squared plus 4 plus our D of S is negative 4 times S plus 0 all over S squared plus 4 squared, no? Then simplifying this one. Okay, so we will have 1 over s plus, that will be negative, no? We should have 4 minus, so minus s, this one is the other part of this fraction, no? So this is s plus 0 over s squared, so we could separate this, that one into two fractions, so the other other one will just be equal to 0, so the remaining one will be s over s squared plus 4. So same for this one, so the remaining will just be negative 4s over s squared plus 4. This is now our partial fraction for this given rational fraction, no? So we could say that the Laplace transform of 16 over s squared plus, no, this s over s squared plus 4 is equal to this inverse Laplace transform of 1 over s minus s over s squared plus 4 minus 4s over s squared plus 4. So using the property of the linearity property of our Laplace transform, so we could have that one as 1 over s minus inverse Laplace of s over s squared plus 4 minus 4s over s squared plus 4. This will be squared, no? This one also, this will be squared, and this one will be squared. So we will have the inverse Laplace for this one is just equal to 1, no? Minus, so this will be cosine, no? Cosine 2t, no? 2t, and for this one, no? This is just the reverse, no? The inverse of this will be the Laplace transform of derivative or derivative transform. So this will be equal to negative t. So this is 1 over s squared plus 4, so that will be sine 2 sine 2 t, no? So and this will be now our answer for the inverse Laplace transform of 16 over s squared plus s times s squared plus 4. Okay, so let's have this another example, no, in which we are going to get the inverse Laplace transform of 1 over s cubed s squared plus 1. Okay, so we just have here our solution. So first we will dissolve our given rational fraction into its equivalent partial fraction, no? So we have a quadratic factor for this one and a linear which is repeated, so that will be a over s plus b s squared plus c s squared. We have plus b s plus e all over s squared plus 1. Okay, then by multiplying both sides by the denominator, now this one, so we have 1 is equal to a s squared times s squared plus 1 plus b s squared plus 1 plus c s squared plus 1 plus d s plus e times s cubed. Okay, so this will be cubed, no? Then we just do some algebraic manipulation for this one before we do our equating equations. This will be a s to the fourth plus a s squared, no? Plus b s squared, no, b s cubed plus b s plus c s squared plus c plus ds to the fourth plus es cubed. Okay, this will be ds cubed. Okay, so now we will equate coefficients, no? a great deal. Coefficients. So we have s to the fourth, so 0 is equals to a plus b, no? Then we have s cubed, 0 is equal to b plus e. So equation 1, equation 2, okay, s squared, so that will be still 0 is equal to a plus c, then s is equal to 0, then you have b, no? B, and this will be equation 3, and this will be equation 4. And for our s is 0, the constant, so we have 1 is equals to c, no? Okay. Equation 5. No? So our c is equal to 1. Then from equation 3, so 0 is equal to a plus c. So we know our c is equal to 1. So a plus 1. So a is equal to negative 1. Then from equation 2, no, it will be 0 is equal to b plus e, so we know that our b is 0, no? Plus e, so our e will just be also equal to 0. Then, so we have a, b, c, d, so d, no, from equation 1, okay, so we know that 0 is equal to a plus d, so our a is equal to negative 1, so 0 is equal to negative 1 plus d. So we could see from this one that our d is equal to 1, no? So in summary, so our a is equal to negative 1, our d is equal to 0, our c is equal to 1, b is equal to 1, and e is equal to 0. So we're going to go back to our partial fraction, no? So we could see that the 1 over, we should write here in the pen of color, so 1 over s cubed, s squared, plus 1 is equals to a over s squared, now a over s, plus b over s squared, plus c over s cubed, then plus d s e over s squared plus 1. So we have now value for our a, that will be negative 1, so negative 1 over s. We have b, that will be 0 over s squared, so this will be equal to 0. Then our c is 1, so 1 over s cubed. And our d is equal to 1, so that will be s plus our e is 0 all over s squared plus 1. No? If I have to simplify this expression further, so we could have that one as negative 1 over s plus 1 over s cubed plus, so this part will be equal to s over s squared plus 1, no? And this one just be equal to 0. We're going to separate this one as two fractions. So it will be 1 over s squared plus 1, no? So we have to get the Laplace transform now. Over 1 over s cubed x squared plus 1. So we will have the inverse Laplace of negative 1 over s plus negative inverse Laplace of 1 over s cube. So just apply immediately the linearity theorem of the Laplace transform, no? 1 over s squared plus 1. Okay, so we now have this will be equal to so this will be equal to negative 1. Then we will have this will be t squared, but we need a 2 factorial, so we'll just have that plus 1 half. Yeah, that will be t squared. Then this will be cosine, no? Plus cosine t. Okay. So, arranging this one, so we have 1 over t squared minus negative 1 plus cosine t. And this will now be our answer. Okay? So, this is the solution for the Laplace transform of 1 over s cubed times s squared plus 1. Okay? So, I hope you understand something in this video, no? Especially on how to get the inverse Laplace transform of functions using partial fractions, no? The distinct linear, distinct repeated, and this one, the quadratic factor, repeated and distinct. Okay? So, see you again in the next video. And as always, enjoy learning.